everyone, welcome to Something's Cooking with Alpa, and today we are going to make Bharwa Baingan ki recipe. It is an absolutely delicious recipe and it's very easy to make. So now let's look at the process. So for this recipe, guys, I'm going to take a small blender, and to this blender I'm going to add 6 tablespoons of fresh coconut, which is gila nariyal, followed up by 7 tablespoons of roasted peanuts, which is singdane ka bhukka, and 15 cloves of garlic, which is lasun. And yes, 15 cloves. I know that's a lot, but we need a lot of garlic and ginger in this recipe. And I'm just adding 1 inch of ginger, which is adrak in here, 1/4 cup of fresh cilantro, which is dhania, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, which is jeera. And now we are going to give it a good blend. Now guys, if you need to add a little bit of water in here so that it blends properly, please go ahead and do so. And now let's remove it in a bowl. So have you clicked on the bell icon after subscribing? If not, do it right now to get an update each time I upload a new recipe, and it's totally free. And once we have removed this paste in the bowl, let's add 1 finely chopped big onion, follow it up by 1 tablespoon of Kashmiri red chili powder and 1 tablespoon of spicy red chili powder in here. Then let's follow it up by 1 tablespoon of coriander cumin powder, which is dhania jeera powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, which is haldi powder, 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala, and then 1.5 tablespoon of godha masala or kala masala. And if you can't find either of them, then just add 1/2 teaspoon extra of the garam masala. But guys, you got to order this online if you can't find it in the nearby store. It is just absolutely delicious. And then we are going to add salt as per our taste and give it a good mix. We are going to use this masala to stuff the brinjals as well as to make the gravy. So we are going to use 1/2 of the masala to stuff the brinjal, and remaining masala we are going to use it for the gravy. So don't be worried if you see so much masala and you feel like, okay, how am I going to use this? We are going to utilize each and every bit of it. And now over here I have taken 6 brinjal or small eggplants, and we are going to remove the leaves of this brinjal, all the dead leaves or the leaves which are sticking to the brinjal. Let's remove that, and then we are going to cut 1/2 of the stem of the brinjal. There we go. And once we do that, then we are going to slice it 3/4 of the way from 2 sides. So one side right now, and now we go the other side. Don't go all the way through. Now we got ourselves some pockets to fill the masala. And now guys, we are simply going to add a little bit of salt to the insides of this brinjal. This will give our brinjal some taste, otherwise it will taste a little bland. So just not for it to taste bland, we added some salt. And now we are going to fill in that masala that we had prepared. So let's fill it in one pocket, and then once we are done with the one pocket, then let's open the other side and fill it in the other side as well. Be very generous with the masala. We have tons of masala, so don't be stingy. And now we are simply going to repeat the process with the rest of the brinjals. And as you can now see, I have all my 6 brinjals filled in with the masala, and I have chopped 1 large potato into 4 parts. And now in a kadhai, I'm going to add 4 tablespoons of oil, and once it is hot, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, which is rye. And once it starts to splutter, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of jeera, which is cumin seeds, followed up by a pinch of hing, which is asafoetida, and 1/2 of that prepared masala or whatever the leftover masala is. That's what we are going to add in here. And then we are going to give it a good mix. Once it's nicely mixed, we are going to cook it for the next 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, or once the masala starts oozing out a little oil, we are going to one by one drop in the brinjal pieces and then the potato pieces. And once everything is nicely mixed in, the potatoes are covered with the masala, the brinjals are covered with the masala, we are going to add 1.5 cup of hot water. Make sure that the water is nice and hot, otherwise it will change the taste of the gravy. And now guys, we are going to add just
half teaspoon of jaggery. You can also alternate it with some sugar, or you can altogether skip it. But adding jaggery does give a very nice taste. So let's do that and give it a nice mix. And we are just going to wait till the time we see our gravy bubbling. And now that our gravy is bubbling, let's cover the lid and cook it for the next 8 to 10 minutes or until the brinjals are nicely cooked. So after 10 minutes, let's uncover the lid, give it a quick mix, and isn't our dish looking absolutely gorgeous? I know your mouth is watering, but let's just garnish it. So I'm going to add a little bit of dhania or fresh cilantro in it. Give it a quick mix and then we are going to remove it in our serving plate or a bowl. And guys, you can enjoy this with rice, roti, or even bhakri. And it is going to be absolutely delicious.
So guys, you saw how easy this recipe is to make. Do make it. Do let me know what you think about it. There's hardly anyone who will not like this dish. And guys, if you do like this recipe, then don't forget to click on the subscribe button. And if you like this recipe, you're definitely going to like this one as well as this one. So do click on these links and I'll see you very, very soon. Meanwhile, you take care. Bye-bye.